My name is Cristine Legare. I'm an associate professor in the psychology department at the University of Texas at Austin. I'm a cognitive scientist and my expertise is in cognitive development. One of my research interests include how both children and adults integrate scientific and religious explanations for the same events, how this works cross-culturally and over the course of development. Although scientific and religious explanations are often presented as contradictory or incompatible in popular science or popular media dialogues about these topics, the psychological research demonstrates that people integrate and reconcile supernatural or religious and natural and scientific explanations with no problem. In fact, there's a lot of evidence that people integrate or reconcile these different explanatory frameworks in very universal and very predictable ways. And the way that they do this is they use scientific and religious explanations to explain multiple levels of causality. So one way this might work is that a religious explanation is used to explain a why question, and a scientific explanation is used to answer a how question. So it's really about multiple levels of causality. The research that I've done has demonstrated there are at least three ways that people integrate or reconcile scientific and religious explanations. One of the ways is called target-dependent reasoning. And to give you an example from the topic of our biological origins, people might use a religious explanation to explain human evolution and human origins, but might use an evolutionary or natural explanation to explain the evolution of other kinds of organisms, microorganisms or other kinds of animals. In the case of synthetic reasoning, people will bring both scientific and religious explanations to bear to explain, say, origins, but won't do it in a very integrated way. So one example would be if you ask somebody to explain our origins, they might say, well, God might be involved, there might be a creationist process, but also evolution might be at play. So both are involved, but there's not a lot of integration. In the third way, which I call integrative reasoning, people use both scientific and religious explanations to explain different levels of causality in a kind of proximate distal way. So one example would be evolution would be used to explain the more proximate process, and creationist process or God would be used to explain the more distal process. So why did we evolve? God, how did we evolve? Through a process of evolution, which may be scientifically verifiable, etc. So the way people integrate natural and supernatural or scientific and religious explanations is very predictable. Very highly constrained by our reasoning process. We use them to explain multiple levels of causality.